What's up, though? It's your girl, Jay Jones. I am here to talk about some of the things that I am encouraging the women in 2019 to obtain, to do. No shade, but it is time. It is time to wear our crown and walk in who we are as queens, walking our queenliness, all right? So, here's what I want you to do. 2019, we're being chased, okay? Just say that to yourself. You're being chased in 2019. We're not taking our crown off. We're not getting off of our throne for any or anything or anyone, okay? We're setting standards, we're setting boundaries, and we're not gonna drop our standards or boundaries for anyone or anything, okay? Let's start there, all right? So, in my studying and in my reading, or whatever, like, I really was doing some self-reflecting on 2018, and, you know, like, this was a real learning year for me. This was a closure year for me. I really believe that me becoming single again, me either restoring or losing friends, me getting a different and better relationship with myself and with God has allowed me to have a different perspective on how I want to go into 2019. This self-awareness type of feeling that I have, this self-identity that I have, like being comfortable with who I am, knowing who I am, knowing whose I am, first and foremost, knowing that I'm loved and not having to receive that love from anybody else but God and myself. And then I'm able to give love freely and unconditionally or whatnot, you know, the way that God loves me. And so because I have come into that type of awareness or whatnot, understanding and knowledge of myself, I want to share a couple of things that I'm doing going into 2019. It's gonna be great. All right, so sorry guys, let me roll a window down. It's hot, y'all. Oops, it's hot. I'm in the car because I need the sun, because okay, so some of the things I'm doing in 2019 is I am practicing chastity. Okay, so for the past 4 years, I've been in a relationship and I have struggled throughout this relationship. My conviction, my faith has waved up and down, you know, like, why am I with this man and why is he this way? And he loves me, but he doesn't show it in the ways that I want him to show it. You know, and it's just, it was a back and forth battle, you know, like, I had my first kid, my only kid, Charlie. And, you know, for her in particular, I have to change what I allow when it comes to relationships with men. I've just got to change it because I want there to be such a standard for her in the future that she knows, like, nah, my mom didn't accept this, so I'm not accepting it, first and foremost. And two, I mean, it's just not what God would have me to do. You know, God wouldn't want me to be in a relationship, be miserable, you know, like, not follow his will and his way. Being in the will of God, you're not supposed to have sex before you're married. And I was having sex before I was married. I'm not shocked that the relationship didn't work. So in 2019 and until, I will not be practicing fornication. Just, it is what it is. The only thing that I have never participated in is married sex. I've done every other type of sex, okay? I'm good, all right? And no good has come from it. So I had to change my perspective. I had to change, you know, like, the way that I want to be treated. You know, I've got to set boundaries. I've got to set standards. I've got to put my sleeve. And it ain't for everybody, okay? It ain't for everybody. That's cool. That's fine. Some people going to watch this video and be like, oh, shoot, she ain't. No, she ain't gonna never have a man. You know what? So big that I believe that God is going to allow me to not only get through this process, but be by the end of this process, I will find the man that I'm supposed to be with. That he will find me, because the Bible says a man that finds a woman finds a good thing and obtains favor from God. Okay, and I know I'm a good thing. All right, let me tell you. Sorry. All right. Anyways, so being chased, this idea of being chased in 2019, you know, like, not allowing, you know, it's almost going to be like, let's say I got 100 guys who see me. They just see me. They don't know me. They just see me and they want to be with me. The moment that I tell them that I'm practicing chastity, how many of those guys are going to drop off the map? How many? And that's fine, because that is not, those aren't who are supposed to be for me. They're not meant for me. But the ones that stay behind, you know, like, who's gonna go through the process. It's almost like doing a job application. You ever did a job application and it was like 4 pages long? You were sitting on the computer for like an hour and then you went to the interview and you got the interview, and then they asked you to come back for another interview, and then they asked you to come back for a third interview, and then the person who, you know, like hires you, you just like, oh my God, thank God, or whatever, because it was just like the longest process ever. But the reward that comes from that, you know what I'm saying? Like, not only were they doing the process of where, okay, first of all, we gonna wing out all the people who gonna, you know, we put this job application up, but we gonna wing out a whole bunch of people because nobody's gonna wanna do the process. No one's gonna wanna do the application. No one's gonna sit for an hour at the computer and do the application. No one's gonna come back for the second and third interview. They're gonna be like, dang, why is it taking so long? Because they know what their value is. They know what they're saying. They know what they can offer. And you get that job and it come with all types of benefit, come with paid vacation, come with sick days, you just get all types of bonuses and commissions. Your bosses be like, you know what, work from home today, like all of the things that come with that job. Just like, you just like, yes, money, good salary, I know what I'm making week to week, and I get bonuses. I'm so glad I did that application. I'm so glad I went through the process. I'm so glad that I took the time to get dressed every single interview and go and wait just to see what the end was going to be. And look at God. In the same way, that is how I want to be approached and processed and chased and groomed when I'm waiting on my man. That's just what that's just, the analogy is just so big for me right now that I'm just like, no, my why for why I'm doing it is so much bigger than me denying my flesh. Like, I can deny my flesh for this. Okay, I tell my friends all the time who, you know me and who know of my struggles in the past with like sex and, you know, things like that and different guys and stuff like, oh, and we'll get into those things in different videos, but for right now, like, what I'm saying is, I gotta turn my ear on, guys. I'm hot. The sun is like right here. It's right here. Anyways, but what I'm saying is, okay, let me, there we go. What I'm saying is that you gotta have your why. You gotta have your why. Why do I wanna practice chastity? Why do I wanna be chaste? Why? My why is so much greater than me. You know what I'm saying? Like, my why is gonna be the reason why I get through this whole process or whatnot. So that's the first thing that I'm doing. And while I'm doing this, secondly, while I'm doing this, while I'm practicing this chastity walk or whatnot, I'm going to be just working on myself. You know what I'm saying? Getting to know myself. How many people know themselves? I mean, you know a little bit about yourself. You know what I'm saying? You know that you're kind. You know that you're giving. You know that you're caring. You're loving. You know, you have all of this love to give or whatnot, but you don't love yourself. How can you have all this love to give the world, but you don't know yourself? Like, you can't give something that you don't have. Like, if someone calls me and asks me for $100 and all I have is $100, then I don't have it to give. I don't have it to give. Same with self-love. If I don't love me, how can I love you in wholeness? So I gotta love me. I gotta take the time to heal from my broken places, things that I've gone through in my past, things that I'm ashamed about. I gotta be able to deal with me or whatnot. It just can't be the good parts. It's gotta be all of me. It's gotta be all of me. Like, you know, for those of us who walk around with guilt and shame and disappointment and, you know, like, bear that weight of things, let it go. Come to peace with it so that you can heal and that you can move forth in your journey in life, okay? So that you can allow that love to be received and given again or whatnot. I know it's people who, you know, have been divorced or whatnot. You walk around that game. It's people who been molested. It's people who gotten abortions. It's people who, you know, all types of things. You gotta love yourself. You gotta, like, look, accept that. Own it. Own that. It is what it is. Own it. Okay? Like, you're not going to get ahead if you're still looking in the past and worried about things that happened in your past. So for the first, like, I'm going into 60 days, February 2nd of my chastity journey. And I know that ain't a long time for y'all, but for me, that's a long time. Okay.